Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the shop. I've got the head of this little Barker PM mill all clean and painted, and I'm getting ready to piece it back together. But if you remember from the disassembly video, I had to file the end here in order for me to slip the cone pulley off. And that was due to whoever had it taken apart last beat on the end of it with a hammer, and it flared it out. So before I can put this back together, I'm going to have to fix these threads in order for me to get this nut to slip back on. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to take it over to the lathe. I'm going to hold this in the forejaw. We're going to indicate on this bearing surface. I'll support this end with a steady rest. And then we'll use a threading tool to pick up these threads. And then we'll chase them until we can get that nut to thread back on. So let's head over to lathe and get it fixed. Okay, I've got the spindle mounted in the forejaw. I have it indicated, and this end supported with the steady rest. And I have my threading tool square to the work. Now we can go ahead and go about picking up the threads. Now the first thing that we need to do is we need to take up the backlash in the lead screw and half nut. Now I've got my half nuts engaged right now, and if I move the hand wheel back and forth, you can see that there's quite a bit of backlash, and we need to take that up before we can actually line up our tool. And the way that I like to do that is you go ahead and engage your half nuts. I've got my tool backed out far enough so it's not going to run into the work, and I'm just going to turn the lathe on and let the tool run in until we're somewhere in the middle of the threads there. Now that we've taken up the backlash, what I like to do at this point is I like to lock the carriage. That way, while I'm moving the tool around, I'm not going to accidentally bump the carriage and knock it out of alignment. Now at this point, you can go ahead and move your tool around using the cross feed and the compound, and you just line up your tool until you're in line with those threads. That looks pretty good right there. Now what we want to do is bottom out the threading tool in the threads and set the crossfeed to zero, the crossfeed dial to zero. That way you know what the full depth is. Then we'll go ahead and back the tool all the way out. And what we're going to do now is we're going to check to make sure that the tool is tracking. Now this is 14 threads per inch. Because it's an even number of threads, we can catch the threading dial on any number or any line. So we'll go ahead and turn the lathe on. We'll engage our half nuts. And as you can see that the threading tool is tracking the threads perfectly. Okay, now that we got the threading tool set up, we can go ahead and make our cuts. I went ahead and painted it with a Sharpie just so that we can see what's going on. Now, while you're doing this, you want to rid yourself of any distractions, because if one slip up and you're going to completely ruin the threads. You know, if you have to, lock the door to your workshop, turn the radio off, turn your cell phone off. Because like I said, one wrong move and it's going to completely ruin your threads. Now, as I said before, this is a even number of threads, so we can catch the threading dial on any number or any line. Now the first cut that I'm going to make, I'm going to stay shy of the full depth, about 15 thousandths shy of the depth, and we'll see where that gets us. Now you don't want to turn the half nuts off because that'll ruin the threads. I like to just stop the lathe, back my tool out, disengage the half nuts, and bring it back. And now we can make our next pass. That last one was 15 thousandths from full depth. Now we'll go to 10 thousandths, the full depth. We'll stop the lathe, pull out the threading tool, disengage the half nuts, and bring it back. Now that was 10 thousandths from full depth. I'm going to go ahead and take my nut and just see how it still need to go a little bit further. So I'm going to stay shy about 5 thousandths. Wait for a number to come around. Turn the lathe off. Back out the tool. Disengage the half nuts. Almost there. And there she goes. Threads on perfect. Like I said, you just want to go slow. Take light cuts so that you're not going to go in too deep. Make sure you have any kind of distractions turned off or locked away. Just pay attention. Like I said before, any kind of wrong move that you make will completely ruin the threads that you're chasing. And with that, that'll do it for this video. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.